guys, welcome back to this video. I am down in the goat barn and today I'm going to show you the kitting kit for our goats that I have been compiling with love, sweat, and tears for the last few weeks so that we're completely ready on kitting day. And kitting day is coming in a week. We have 7 days until our first goat is officially due. So this is where I have everything set up. I have this little corner of our barn. This is where the kids are gonna be born. So we're gonna start off in this stall over here, which is not prepared. Oh, well, hello. I don't know if you guys can see what's happening here, but there may or may not be a little tiny dog stalking a cat. Anyway, I'm going to get all the stuff that I need for this stall. Sam's getting me more hay. He was going to do it this week. Today has been super busy, so probably tomorrow. I have to do a lot of my feed shopping tomorrow, so we'll probably go out and get the straw that I need. So we're going to be using this stall for our kitting stall. I'm going to be cleaning it out. It's got some cobwebs over there in the corner. So I set this little place up. This is where we're going to hang out. We're going to have a little heater if it's really cold when the first kid comes and it's supposed to get cold again. And then this is the shelf. I have like a blanket there. I have an extension cord if I need it. I have everything just set up here just so it's so handy right outside the stall. In fact, if I need to be in there and need to be doing anything, nobody else even needs to be there. They can just reach what I need and pass it through the bars. Ellie's like, oh, I'll do it. All right, so I am missing one thing, and I'll tell you what that is at the end. And I also want to label the drawers so that it's easier for people to see, but I think already that I already know where everything is. So I'm going to start at the bottom. I'm going to show you that I have some goat sweaters, and I actually have more goat sweaters than this. That's only for if it's extremely cold out and or in the middle of the night. So here it gets really, really cold in the night, even if the days get a little bit more warm. So it's only for the first few days when baby goats have a hard time regulating their temperatures, and only if needed and probably just at night. And then I have a bunch of big towels for kitting, for drying off kids, because in the winter especially you want to get them dried off really quickly. I am going to bring down a blow dryer as well, especially if it's really cold when the kid comes. All right, so here I have my Chucks pads. I have a bunch of those. Those are hopefully what kids would be born onto so that they come into the world and onto a clean surface. And that's really important because as that cord is breaking, it pulls it tight and kind of severs it off so nothing goes up inside there. But you never know, bacteria can still get up there. So you want your baby to be born on something that's nice and clean. That's what these are for. I'll explain these. I have a bottle. I don't know if we're gonna bottle any of our babies. We probably are gonna introduce a bottle and try and bottle once a day to start. I have garbage bags. These are just little garbage bags. Obviously, these are gonna be messy and they're gonna need to go into a garbage bag. So these are like those parachute cords. So these are really super interesting. I'm gonna show you. So essentially, sometimes you will include one of those little hook things that go inside, wrap around the baby's legs and help pull the babies out. But because our goats are small, they're Nigerian dwarf, I worry about that being too big. And people say that it's so big, and a lot of people say they never use it. So if a situation did occur that I had to pull a baby, which you never want to pull unless you have to, you can do this. You can tie this little knot like that, and then you can, it's so tiny, you put it in, you use your fingers, you wrap it around the baby's feet, tighten it a little bit, and you can keep your hands there, and then you can use this to pull the baby out. And it is just a gentler way, a smaller thing to go inside just a tiny goat. So hopefully we never ever have to use that, but I want to be prepared. This kit, I definitely want to be prepared. And then I bought this book, this little journal. It says, "Enjoy the little things." I love the color of it. And I thought this was really fitting because our goats are little. So enjoy the little things, you know, the babies. So it's just a journal. And I'm going to use that and these pens to record all my notes, things that I don't want to forget. I said in a recent video that it can get really tricky remembering which baby belongs to which mom. because even though they know who their mom is, it can be too hard for us, especially if you have like same colored goats bred to the same buck. So I want to make notes and just record all the information that I don't want to forget. And when in the heat of the whole birthing situation, in the heat of the whole birthing experience, it can be super exciting. You know, when goats are giving birth, it can be super exciting and you get doing all the things that you need to get done. And the babies are so exciting that you forget to record stuff. So, or you just forget stuff. I want to have my book here so that I can record it as things happen so that I know I want to record like how many kids a doe has, the date, the fact that they're a first freshener or if it's their second time or just all the information. This is where all the important stuff is. In here, I have like a syringe for drenching, like giving medications. I have some OB gloves. So these are the ones, there's 10 of them in here. They go all the way up your arm in case you ever had to really go in, which I don't think that that's gonna happen. Knock on wood. Knock on wood. I have other gloves, just the regular gloves. I have some Tums. You guys know Tums is good for if you need to give calcium to your goat. And a reason that you might want to give calcium to your goat is if their contractions are not super strong or if it's taking a longer time. Just, it's something super easy to administer. They love them. And it can just help with the labor. Same with raspberry leaf tea, which I might also add. I have iodine. That is for dipping the baby's cord, even though when the cord tears, it kind of seals off, like I was saying earlier. You're likely gonna want to dip it anyway because you're gonna likely need to trim it up anyways. And so when you do that, it's good to dip it in iodine. I have this little old pill bottle that I plan to dip it. So there are two ways that people think about this. Some people just spray the cord and say it's sufficient because when it tears, it kind of locks it in, so no bacteria can get in. But then other people say that when you, so most people think that spraying the cord is appropriate. But then other people say if you dip the cord, which I think is the recommended way, that it enables iodine to go up the, to travel up the cord a little bit to like really give them extra protection. So I have that. All right, so let's see. So in here, I also have my nasal aspirator, little syringe. I have this little light, which is a headlight. So I'm excited about that because it's so much easier if you have your hands, if you actually need to assist the doe. So you put this light on your head and you can see so much better and you don't have to worry about trying to hold a light. I have a thermometer, and thermometers obviously are used to check for a fever. And I have some little swabs that I can clean the thermometer with. So all that stuff I keep in this side, this little tiny bag, and I hope the batteries don't die in the cold. I think it's super handy to keep it in a little bag because then somebody can just throw it through the bars. I can be like, just pass me that little blue bag and everything is kind of there together. You can keep it in the stall with you. I have some vet wrap. That's really good in case you have an emergency prolapse. Really easy to fix a prolapse and make it so that it doesn't get any worse by using vet wrap. I have some paper towel here. And over here I have my molasses, which is a superfood. I keep telling everybody about that. Molasses is full of B vitamins. It's full of a lot of vitamins, but really, really high in B vitamins. It can be given to almost any animal for pick me up, to give them energy. It's just something that is so beneficial. You can get like a NutriDrench or something for goats, which is kind of does the same thing. I'm choosing to use molasses soaked in warm water after giving birth. It can rejuvenate a doe and give her the energy she needs to care for her baby. So I have scissors. I have medications. I also brought down some pain medication. I have a bunch of medications in here. I have needles. I have scissors. All of these things are just things that I might need during the birth. This for sure to give the doe some energy. The medications like pain relief in case you do have to go in and the doe, or if the doe has like a hard delivery. Or at least I have all of it down here, so I'm prepared. I think that's it. That's all I have. So the other thing that I'm missing that I really need to get is some lube. I'm gonna pick that up tomorrow. And I think I'm gonna add another flashlight. This barn is fully lit up. We have really good lighting in this barn, so the flashlights might not be as necessary, but when you're in like an enclosed space and you're dealing with the back end of a dough. Definitely flashlights are super helpful. So all I have left is to prepare the stall. I wanted to wait until the very end so that no bacteria, no germs can kind of settle in there. This is our first mama here. She's the one that's gonna go first. And she's laying out there in the cold area, not tucked into a corner. She must be hot. Like I said, I suspect she's a first freshener. See, that little goat is such a noisy little thing. I suspect she's just having one kid and she's a small goat, and that is not my favorite situation, but we are prepared and we're going to deal with it. Another thing, so as I prepare the kidding stall, I am going to add a heat source. Probably that will be a heat lamp. I'll get that already if we need it. Hopefully we don't need it, but if we do need it, I want it to be down here. I want to be prepared. I don't want to have to go searching for things, especially while we're waiting to make sure that the kid is nursing and doing okay. I don't want to have to be like leaving and searching for everything. So we'll have a little heat source down here. They're all chewing their cud and staring at me, which is so funny. They honestly, when I come out here and I'm videoing, they all just stand here and stare at me and watch and listen to what I'm saying. Like, they have no idea what is actually happening. I have a few heavy, heavy blankets. So this is super heavy and this is super heavy. Those are for Sophie and I, or whoever comes down here with me and is gonna hang out and wait for the birth. So I know sometimes people end up sitting out for like 3 or 4 hours while they're waiting for a baby to be born. So now that I've showed you everything that we have, minus the lube that I actually need to still get. It actually doesn't seem like a lot of stuff, but maybe it's because I have it all in such a organized way in that container. Usually I see people have like a basket or a bag and it seems all full and stuffed. I'm feeling super prepared and super ready for these kids to start coming. Our first one is due in 1 week. Like I said, she's having one baby, likely having one baby. So there's a good chance that she'll go a little over her due date. So within the next like 7 to 10 days maybe. And then the other should follow suit really soon after. And I think both of them look like they are having twins. They kind of feel like they're having twins, but you never know. Even if you get an ultrasound, you still don't always know how many babies a kid will have, because especially if you do the ultrasound early, then when you're supposed to, you can count kids, but lots of times kids get reabsorbed, and it happens with all species, actually, or it happens with people too. It happens with a lot of species. A kid will get reabsorbed, so you never know for sure the final count. And then if you get an ultrasound when the babies are a little bit bigger, they are too big usually to really tell numbers. You can kind of guess. Sometimes you see shadows. Sometimes like it's really difficult to tell and get an accurate count of babies on an ultrasound for all those reasons. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I'm super excited for the birth of our first kids on our farm. I have been there to watch kids be born before, never been solo. And I think my sister will come if I need her. She is a pro. Get ready, because we are about to enter kid heaven. Don't you know that you're beautiful? Just the way you are, just the way you came. Don't you know that you're beautiful? With lots of new babies being born on our farm.
Oh, I am freezing. I feel so bad for that baby. I feel bad for you. She's like, well, then give me food. I put hay over there so that she always has some place she can go to eat. I just feel bad for her because she doesn't really fit into the herd, but it matters to her. Like, some goats are like, yeah, whatever, I'll just go stand over here. But she is so noisy. Hi, Rosie. Hi, baby girl. Rosie is our only goat that's not pregnant. And he was telling me today that she's coming into heat because he tried to mount her. And that's what's really good about having a wether. A lot of people believe that you don't need a boy goat on a farm other than a buck, obviously. Some people believe that you don't need a boy on a farm other than a buck. But for us, the wether is really useful. Yeah, you're really useful because
They're really good at babysitting babies. So like when you're starting the weaning process or you separate them to milk, then they are really good at taking care of babies. And he is really good with our baby. In fact, he is stalled with our baby at night because he's good to her. But another reason I love having a weather around is because he always tells us when our does come into heat, because he'll always try and mount them. Even though he can't breed with them, he still will always try and mount them. Look at her. Isn't she the sweetest girl? She's looking really chubby. Woo! Do you guys remember when we had him castrated? It took forever for his boy bits to fall off, and I never followed up to see if they even did fall off, but they were there for, and I still think he has them. I think he still has the sack. No, I don't see anything. Things you never thought you'd see on a horse channel, but he looks empty. Whoa. And her udder is really growing. Sometimes I come out here and just try and walk behind them quietly and pretend I'm not doing anything and look at their udders. These ones that are due in a couple of weeks, they're not first fresheners and they really aren't growing a lot. Also, I was thinking that once the babies get a little bit bigger, I might, when we start weaning them so that we can milk, I might end up putting them with her, with that little girl, because she's young. Hopefully she'll be kind to them. We'll see. She's a gentle goat for sure. But we'll see, and maybe she'll go with the babies and kind of babysit them, because... And then maybe she'll have a place to fit in, because I feel really sad for her that she doesn't fit in. So today I want to move my feed room. I'm torn. So this is my feed room. It's super tiny. It gets messy because it's hard to get in here to clean because it's so tiny. I love it because it's sunny. It's so bright. It is close to this part where the duck and the goose are. So that's why I love it. I love it because it's sunny and bright, and I love sunny and bright. But I want to move it. I want to change this up because very soon we are going to be getting a baby. Pretty soon, very soon, we're going to be getting a pig. And so I want to use this area for him. We can fill this with straw and make like a nice cozy bed for him. We can hang toys up along here for enrichment for him. Like, there's a lot of stuff we can do in this little area for a pig. So I'm gonna end up moving all my feed stuff in here, which is great because if I needed to turn the heat on for something, I don't know, it's really great in here because I have the fridge in here, I have shelves in here, I have a table in here. I mean, this is really, and I have the water in here. So this is really a good feed room. But it's dark and I hate it dark. But still, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna set this room up. And as I do that, I'm gonna tell you guys all about our new pig. Once winter is over, I think that if we take this thing off, this plastic thing, that it will really let in a lot more light. And I'd like to be able to get up there and clean all this stuff out. It's disgusting. Maybe our cat would like to lay up there. I could make that a cat bed. But anyway, so that's what's gonna happen right now. I am going to turn this little area into our feed room. While I do that, I am going to tell you guys all about our new pig. We've already made arrangements to get him. And I'm gonna tell you his breed and everything I know about him. And maybe I'll include a picture if I can find one. Thank you.
All right, so definitely a lot fuller in here. I'm excited to like organize this a little bit better. I think I'm gonna make this the pig food area and the duck and the goose food area. I just need to get some other better buckets because this bucket over here is what's holding my duck food. I want to be able to have it on here so it's just easy to grab. I might just empty it into a garbage can like I have over here. I actually wish those fit under the table and I wanted to put wheels on them so they could roll in and out, but for now, until I figure it out, they're just gonna sit here and then I have like my minerals and all the vitamins and stuff that the goats get in their feed on that table, and they're sharing it with the cat food. And then I have my water over here, which makes it super handy. So I'm gonna sweep this out and I have a bunch of bags that I'm saving because in a pinch, these things are so good for things. Like say in the spring when we do like a big spring clean out and we want to sell manure, we have lots of horse manure that should be pretty close to being ready. That's one way that we make money on our farm. We've sold horse manure all the years we've had horses. So I save these bags because they're really good for that. And this whole bag over here is full of it. So all I have left to do is clean out this area. I'm going to move those things into the other room.
It's looking a little brighter in here. All right, it's messy, but I'm doing it with one hand, you guys. And it's cold. So once I get, so I'm gonna probably leave a pallet in here and put all these blankets and stuff in there, and I'm gonna fill this with hay and maybe build some like trough, like a little trough along the side to put his food in. I'm gonna clean this all out. This is gonna be our pig, our pig's home. This is where he's gonna live. I'm excited about him. That is it for today's video. It was a solo video done almost only by me because the kids have friends over and they're gonna be busy for the whole next 24 hours enjoying their friends. They're gonna be playing VR and having lots of snacks. He bought a ton of snacks. I asked Elizabeth to send me a list of the kind of snacks that she wanted, and she sent me a list. This is a joke, okay? This was a joke, and I know her sense of humor, so I knew it was a joke, but it made me laugh. So she sent me a list of like the black bag Doritos, mints, the kind of chocolate she likes, and then at the very end of the list it said Fireball whiskey. But obviously we are not a drinking family and we don't let our kids drink. Occasionally they have a glass of wine at Christmas and at New Year's, but we're not a drinking family and we don't condone the drinking of a minor. But she just makes me laugh because she has such an awesome sense of humor. Hopefully that made you laugh too. Don't you know that you're beautiful?